Lee Joe Stump, and welcome to my instructional video. This is the arpeggio section of the instructional video. So today we're going to talk about things ranging from basic arpeggio type of execution to more advanced sweep picking and arpeggio play. So let's get started right away. Still in. And so I'm tuned down a half step, so here's my A. So this is actually concert A flat. So if you guys want to tune up, cool. Alright, so arpeggio play, sweep picking, that's what we're going to be talking about. And the basic premise of the sweep picking is you're ascending, you're sweeping down, you're descending, you're sweeping up. There's more to it than that, but that's, you know, that's basically the way it's going. And the one of the best ways, and this is your sweep picking 101, kind of just starting out kind of sweep picking thing. And, you know, maybe in future episodes we'll do some more advanced stuff, or maybe, you know, towards the end we'll get to somewhat advanced stuff. So, and this is the first thing I show everybody when, you know, someone is just wants to get introduced to this type of play. So one thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take the diatonic arpeggios for E natural minor. You know, E natural minor, F, E, F sharp, G, A, B, C, D, E. And I'm going to take the arpeggios built off each degree of the scale, so meaning the chords being E minor, F sharp diminished triad or minor 7 flat 5, G major, A minor, D minor, C major, D major, E minor. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start here, I'm going to play them in 2, 3, 4, and then 5 string arpeggio shapes. Diatonic arpeggios for E natural minor, 2, 3, 4, 5 string arpeggio shape. So I'm going to start here, and with this two string shape, the root of the note, the root of the chord, the note that the chord's named for, is going to be on the second string. So, you know, one big key when you're working on, you know, when you're working on any kind of technique building type of bit, is the metronome, usage of the metronome. So right now I got the metronome banging on 104. And I'm going to start out playing triplets. So I'm playing triplets, three notes on the beat. So my first arpeggio, E minor right here, E, G, and B. And that's a triplet against the click. And then later on, after I go through all of them, I'll play it as a 16th note triplet. So E minor. Now the picking pattern, down, down, up. So there's a small sweep, and obviously a good place to start is just sweeping across two strings. Down, down, up. And that 16th note triple. The first slow, all the arpeggios, E minor. F sharp diminished. G major. A minor, B minor, C major, D major, and then E minor. So I'm going to go up and then I'm going to go back down. So. Thank you. goes as a triplet, now a 16th note, a triplet going to be twice as fast. And that two-string arpeggio, do the same thing in octave lower, and I'm going to play, and that all those arpeggios be the same thing in octave lower, and everything's going to be happening on strings 3 and 4, with the exception of the first E minor I'm going to play on strings 4 and 5. And the rest of the triads will be on your G and E strings, once again with the pick down, down, up. So there's small two-string sweep bit. Now the next arpeggio, I'm going to stick with the two-string bit for a sec, and I'm going to show you a couple different other, you know, couple other different patterns with the two-string shape. This next one, this is just an old school kind of Randy Rhoads, Richie Blackmore, Michael Schenker arpeggio. I mean, when I first started playing arpeggios, you know, my favorite players, Gary Moore, Richie Blackmore, Michael Schenker, Uli John Roth. And then later on, Yngwie, of course. And most of those other players I mentioned were using very small two and three string shapes, and I used to love the little classical sections in a lot of the tunes that went, you know, sometimes went, you know, before the solo or after the solo. So this is this two string arpeggio with a downstroke, a pull off, and another down, like that kind of thing. Very easy, once again, downstroke, pull off. Another down, 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 pull down. And see what, you know, if you check out my right hand when I'm doing that, when I start to play it faster, you can see a little sweep action going on. That kind of thing. So moving up the scale slow. Arpeggios as before, but you know, just a different pattern. Down, pull, down. And that small. Now I'm going to take that same pattern just to show you like all the different possibilities I'm getting just out of these three notes, just on these top two strings. I'm going to take the same pattern and I'm going to, you know, same arpeggio, same leg. I'm just going to change up the beat permeation. So now it's going to go from triplets and sextuplets to a 16th note figure. And this is a very Blackmore-esque kind of thing, and this is a favorite pattern of mine. You know, once again, same technique with the pick, except the rhythmic figure is 16ths. Well, that'd be eighths at, you know, eighths at this permeation. That would be 16ths. A little more deceptive, because you've got a three-note arpeggio, but you're playing, you know, a four-note figure, so a little bit tricky. But in eighth notes, it would be, you know, E minor, F sharp diminished, G major. The other easy portion of this is we only have one major chord, one minor chord, and one diminished shape. I'll talk about some different inversions later on in the video, but right now we're just hanging with one shape of each chord, so that's another thing that makes this portion of this whole, this bit easy. So we got this. Thank you. that kind of thing. Play much faster. So, and there's a two-string bit, and I'll play a couple, now, before I move on with the three-string arpeggios, I'll play a couple small excerpts from some of my tunes with the metronome, utilizing the two-string arpeggios, and this is from, this first bit I'm going to play is contained on your fourth string and your third string, and this is from the, an excerpt from the Psycho Shred Suite, that's the live version of that, which is on the, my last instrumental record, 2001 A Shred Odyssey, so, if you don't own that one, very important that you do. Little shameless self-promotion there, and so the chord sequence, the metronome's clicking quite fast, you know, somewhere in the area of, you know, 236, 240, somewhere around that, on that particular track. So first I'm going to play it in triplets, and the chord sequence is F major. F sharp diminished. G major. G sharp diminished. And then, so those are all four times a piece. That kind of thing, you know, it's neat. Then it goes on two times a piece, A minor, B diminished, C major, C sharp diminished, D minor, D sharp diminished, and then an E major. And on this E major, this is a three string arpeggio straight, excuse me, on strings 4, 3, and 2. And the picking pattern for that one, I'll talk about this, you know, later on in the video. This is down, down, down. Up, pull up. Down, down, down. Up, pull up, down. That type of bit. Alright, so now, so I'll play that whole bit in time slow. And once again, this is that two-string pattern, the first one we reviewed, where I'm going down, down, up. So slow as a triplet in time sounds like this. This is the Psycho Shred bit, fast, two-string bit. Alright, so there's one two-string excerpt. Now I'll play one more, and this is from a short excerpt from Thrill of the Chase, and this is off the Rapid Fire Rondo CD. And first I'll play the whole bit, the section slow. And so that's a descending bit, and all this is diatonic to E minor and E harmonic minor. So I'm going to play that slow first with a click. And this one's banging quite fast. The quarter note on this tune is at 20, you know, somewhere around 208, and I'm playing triplets. But first I'm going to play it slow, and it's that the triads are E minor, D major, C major, B major, then C major, B major, A minor, G major. See that? G major, and then this short run. So in time, that whole section sounds like this. And that's that one we're going down, pulling another downstroke. Play it again slow. Down, pull, and then another down, and then with the click fast, sounds like this. What's more? All right, so you know, so there's a two-string bit. You got a bunch of different two-string patterns, and you have a couple short excerpts to work on. So that so now we're going to move on to some three-string arpeggio shapes. I'm going to go back to the first bit I did where I took the diatonic triads for E minor, you know, and that's basically the way we're going about it, is I'm playing through the diatonic triads for E minor and, you know, playing the sweep shape where I'm adding a note each time, and then I'll go through like a short excerpt from one of my tracks or something like that. So I'm going to hang with that, and now we have one more. All we're doing here is we're taking the top note, we're dropping an octave. Now we got E minor. You know, now it looks more like a chord. E minor, F sharp diminished, G major, A minor, B minor, C major, D major, and E minor. And you can see, and now with the pick, you know, now it's looking more like a full-on sweep shape. Down, 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 up, a pull off, another upstroke. And that's the figure right there, and that's either going to be a triplet or a sextuple. And see that? Down, 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 up, pull, up. Sounds like that, slow. So, slow without the click, I got down, down, and E minor. And all we're doing is taking the top note, as I said before, and doubling it an octave lower, and that's how we're coming up with the next note. Triad, only three notes in the arpeggio: E minor, F sharp diminished, G major, A minor, B minor, C major, D major, A minor. So slow in time. First triplets. All right, so now here it is, you know, fast in time. Obviously, before you start blazing up the diatonic arpeggios within the scale, you can just hang, you know, get a minor shape or a major shape and just hang in one spot and play it. Here's, you know, just B minor right here. Once again, down, 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 up, pull up. Kind of thing. And or another thing you can do is, instead of starting on the third string and going down, 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 up, pull up, down, 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 up, pull up, we're going to start on the top string, and it's just going to be that same exact pattern just turned around, where it's up, pull up, down, 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 up, pull up, down, down, down. So it's up, pull up, down, down, down. Because sometimes it's just like, just same premise of playing an old blues lick. You might think of like, you know, this old kind of Hendrix-y lick, like that kind of thing. I'm sure everybody's heard that before. Or you can think of it as, you know, starting on the third string as opposed to the top string, you know. Once you've repeated it, it sounds exactly the same, but sometimes just thinking of something coming from what, you know, one starting point as opposed to another helps you execute it better. So just hanging in one spot on that E minor. Or, you know, just doing it on a major chord, C major. Practice the diatonic arpeggios that way too, instead of going, you know, start the other way. So there's a three-string arpeggio shape, and, you know, heading in both directions. Now, another thing I'm going to do is, once again, I was playing a triplet or a sextuplet, and now I'm going to change it. I'm just going to add a pull-off to it, and I'm going to change the permeation of the beat to 16ths. And this is a pattern I love to use all the time. Sounds very, very cool. And then I'll give you guys an excerpt with this bit. And so this pattern is... sounds like that slow. And the pattern is down, pull, up, down, 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 up, pull. Once again, down, pull, up, down, pull, up, down, 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 up, pull. That kind of bit. And you can see that's going to change from a trip, you know, from triplet or a sextuplet to eighths or sixteenths. So first an eighth. Now in 16th. All right, so now just to change things up a bit, I'm going to stick with that three-string shape. But the only thing we haven't done is, you know, haven't talked about different versions of the chord, meaning like here's, you know, all these triads, very important. A lot of these sweep shapes are all stemming from your, you know, the chords you first learned up here at the nut of the guitar, just those small triadic shapes played all over the neck. Like this E minor shape is just D minor, you know, the standard D minor you play at the nut. You know, just move that, obviously the root's on the second string, here the root's on the fourth string and the second string. You know, that chord moved up right there. Looks like that, so E minor, you know, in the F sharp diminished triad, that chord shape, major, just like a D chord moved up, and then the minor shape again, minor, major, major. So I'm going to do the same exact thing, but now I'm going to change the scale to, I'm going to go to A harmonic minor, another, you know, two keys very commonly used in rock, metal, shred, whatever you want to call it. So now I'm gonna, the diatonic triads for harmonic minor are the same as natural minor, except for the triads that contain that raised seventh tone. The harmonic minor scale, for those of you that do not know it, is a natural minor scale with a raised seventh tone, or a major seventh tone, or the leading tone, whatever you want to call it. You know, that would be harmonic minor. Natural minor. Good way to get the sound of the scale, you play it one octave. Natural minor. Harmonic minor. Alright, and so the diatonic triads for harmonic minor are A minor, B minor 7 flat 5, or B diminished triad. C augmented. Augmented chord is a major chord with a raised fifth tone. Not a very pleasant sound. D minor. E major. F major. G sharp diminished. You know, raised seven, diminished seven, and then A minor again. All right, so now I'm going to play an arpeggio shape built off each degree of that scale, and this will give you some different inversions to work with. So the picking pattern is the exact same bit. So you got, you know, A minor, and so this is up, pull up, down, down, down. So A minor. B minor 7 flat 5. And that's a bit trickier because you got that note right there. C augmented. D minor. E major. F major, G sharp diminished 7, and then A minor. Cool. So slowly, in time with the click, sounds like this. Some three string excerpts, and the first bit I'm going to do is from the album Supersonic Shred Machine, and this is Demon's Eye, and this is a and so first thing I'll do is I'll go through the arpeggio sequence slow. It's in D minor, as Nigel says, the saddest of all keys. My first Spinal Tap reference in the video. Don't want to use too many, I have to pay those guys a royalty. And Christopher Guest has way more cash than I do. But anyway, D minor, A major, D minor, so that's D minor, A major, D minor, A major again. And that would be a E diminished triad or a C sharp diminished seventh triad right here. Diminished seventh chord you can name for any note in the arpeggio. It's that chord that moves around, you know, every minor third or every three frets and automatically inverts itself. So in the key of D harmonic minor, that's a C sharp diminished seventh arpeggio. That's the diatonic seventh chord in the key. Or, you know, it's a diminished triad, E diminished triad. So that would be that diminished seventh arpeggio. Then drop down a minor third, same arpeggio shape. It's an E, D minor. Slow in time, that sounds like this. Then the second portion of it goes A major, D minor, D minor, C sharp diminished seventh, D minor. So the whole thing slow in time sounds like this. I'll play it in slow in time with the click. Sounds like this. First triplets. And that last bit's a five-string arpeggio shape. We'll get to some five-string shapes later on, but the way to pick this, and this is off of this, off that A major chord right there, you know, your regular root five major bar chord, and it's up, down, 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 up, down, 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 up. That kind of thing. So here's the whole bit, that speed. And then the second time through does the same exact bit, except it resolves. So it goes A major, D minor, D minor, G sharp diminished 7, G sharp diminished 7, G diminished 7, or C sharp diminished 7, I'm sorry. And then up a minor third, and then down D minor. So I played that fast, let me just play the whole thing in time slow for you. So there's a short three-string excerpt. Cool. All right. So now we're All right. So there's a three-string bit. So now we're going to go to the four-string arpeggio shape, and I go back to my diatonic arpeggios for E minor. Now I just stack one more note on, and I have a four-string arpeggio shape. And so the picking for this is down, 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 up, pull, up, up. So you got to remember the basic premise is, as I said in the beginning of the video, you're ascending, you're sweeping down, you're descending, you're sweeping back. Now when I get two notes on a string, meaning I go down, 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 then, you know, I change my pick stroke, up, pull, up, up. So once you get two notes on a string, you change your stroke, and then many times a pull-off accompanies it. So E minor. So I'm going to play this slow in eighths with the click. E minor. F sharp diminished, G major, minor. B minor. C major. D major. E minor. And that, once again, that's down, 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 up, up, up. Down, 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 up, pull, up, up. Sounds like that. And then once again, you can hang in one spot. Yeah, watch, I'll do this, even go back to B minor, two strings, you know. Three strings. Four strings. Once again, I'll play through those diatonic E minor arpeggios. And then, you know, you can go up and down, repeating each one two times, four times, one time a piece. Eighth slower, or eighths at a faster tempo, sixteenths at a slower tempo. You know, I mean, the important thing is where make sure you're playing everything clean and accurately articulate and in time. Four-string excerpt, and this is some of the bit that I played in the beginning of the video, and this is a combination of one bit of it's from the 2001 Shred Odyssey on the title track on that. I'm playing a ton of stuff, and there's a small arpeggio excerpt that's from this, and then there's some of it's from Strat Attack, the arpeggio section of Strat Attack, which is on my first record, Guitar Dominance, the cult classic Guitar Dominance. So, you know. Came out in 93, so this is going to be, so it sounds like this slow. We got E major, four string arpeggio shape to A minor, that's G sharp diminished triad. And then climbs up E major, A minor, G sharp diminished, A minor. So two inversions of A minor, one's based off of this and that, A minor, and then A major, D minor, B major, E major. So I'll play that slow in time. First portion of it, then it goes into the Strat Attack portion. All right, so we got A minor, next higher inversion of A minor, same thing with D minor, G major, and this, that's three string arpeggio shape. So this is a combination of three and four string. Four-string arpeggio shapes. G major. G major. C major. F major. flat major. And then E major. F major. E major. G major. E major. F major. G major. G sharp diminished 7. A minor. B diminished 7. G sharp diminished 7. So all that slow in time sounds like this. Sections now all together, the first four string bit and then that, and all these shapes are, all the mechanics of all these shapes, whether it's a three string or a four string arpeggio shape, have been covered previously in the video. So if you're a little bit dodgy on something, just refer back to earlier. So now I got the five string arpeggio shape, and this is the shape that everybody's most familiar with. And going back to my diatonic triads for E natural minor, so now with the five string shape, I got down, 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 up, pull, up, up, up. Once again, all downs, down, 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 up, pull, up, up, up. And another way you can play this, which you know, some players will do, you play all downs, down, 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 kind of pull, up, up, up. And I'll do that more if I'm doing one of those ones where I'm doing, you know, one of those tap and sweep things. One of those types of bits. But I play it mainly the first way, but I'll use the pull-off if you want, you know, if I want a more legato-esque kind of tone. Alright, so with this bit, and the other thing that a lot of players don't know is that's a five note figure against the click, a quintuplet, so it's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1. Thank you. So now, another thing I'm going to do here is back to the five string bit. Is I had that first bit with the five string, that quintuple, which is. You know, any spot I'll go back to B minor. That kind of thing. So here what I'm going to. So now what I'm going to do, add a hammer on and a pull off, and I change the figure. So this is going to be a triplet or a sextuplet. And this is a shape I like, rhythmic pattern like I like to use all the time with this shape. And it's, so it's down, hammer, pull, up, 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 down, 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 up. Slow with the click and a triplet, it's going to sound like this. And then, alright, so going up the scale. Five string excerpt, and this is going to be, and this is this dominant Phrygian sweep sequence, which is from the 2001 A Shred Odyssey solo, and sounds like this slowing in time. You know, I'll play it slow first, and it's just E major, sorry, no, sorry, E major. You know that pattern I just explained, down, hammer, pull, up, 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 down, 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 down. So slow, it sounds like this. F major. E major. D minor. So the first section, slow in time, sounds like this. Section, I take these two inversions and I connect them. I go this E major, I go, and then I go, and then I go. So what's happening here is I go down this one, and my last note of this inversion becomes the first note of this inversion, and I kind of group them together, do a little figure eight with them. So, and I play that with my first finger. Picking pattern, down, hammer, pull, up, 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 down, 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 up, pull, up, 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 slide, down, 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 up. And I do the same thing with F and D minor. Time that whole bit sounds like this. Mm-hmm. bit more advanced, I jump octaves, I go. And that's exactly the way it is on the disc as well. So here it is fast, dominant Phrygian sweep sequence. So there's a ton of stuff. I hope you find this fun, educational. And thanks for watching. And there'll be other excerpts of this stuff. I'm going to have one on Baroque and neoclassical type of playing. And plus some more mixed in with some more, even more advanced arpeggio stuff. Like I said, this one's geared more towards the, you know, just getting you started sweep-wise and stuff. But some of the excerpts are considerably difficult to play at tempo. Cool. All right, thanks. And informative.